today I'm going to test this Pioneer PL115D. This is how it is looking. This is how it is looking. Beautiful, beautiful turntable. Auto return. And a belt drive. And as you can see, this is how I set the auto scaling and the weight, because I changed it in my Pickering. This is my Pickering element, the, as you can see over here. And I changed that for this one, because this one is a Pioneer. I think still the original, the Pioneer, but this thing didn't sound that good, so I changed it for the Pickering. And anyway, this is how the dust cap is looking, and I can tell you that if you ever buy a turntable with a yellow dust cap, forget that you can ever get it white. I tried to polish it, but the yellow is inside it because of the ultraviolet light from the sun, and the dust cap changes color. And you can polish what you want, but this you will not take. Well, you cannot get it at normal again. So this is a warning for you all. If you ever buy a turntable with a dust cap like this, and you think, well, I can polish that color away, well, think twice. I didn't manage it. I could not take away that yellow color, because it is yellow, as you can see from all sides. So if a dust cap is scratchy, I show you in another video how to do that with a polish machine. Very simple, you can get it like new again. But if it is yellow, forget it, you know, forget it. This one is a good dust cap, because it doesn't, well, it is in one piece, but yeah, the color, eh? Okay, anyway, so I placed this Pickering, and today I'm going to over there my new microphone, the Rode NT4, for the first time I'm going to use it. No, second time, but the first time was a test, and I was very happy with that sound. And this is how, and I use, today, I'm not gonna call names, say names, but I use a Kaseko album, because it is copyright free. I hope it is copyright free, because Shazam did not recognize it. So when Shazam don't recognize it, probably YouTube will not recognize it also. So there's no copyright on this complete album. It's an album from 1977. And that's why I bought these albums. I bought a collection. Some of them, most of these albums, I discovered that they also have copyright. So I cannot use all of these albums I bought. You have to see my other video I just uploaded last week, where I told you, I showed you why I bought these albums. And that is because of, well, that's because of copyright, my friends, copyright. And I thought, well, probably Kaseko music is not very, very famous, and most of these albums will not have copyrights. But I was wrong, because most of these albums have copyrights. So I have to buy more. Just a few, I think 3 albums were without copyright, and that's enough. That's enough for me to review my turntables, because I will sell all my turntables. I need the space, and I have this thing already for quite a while, and I think, okay, let's start with this. And this is how it sounds. This is how it works. So when it is a belt driven thing, so when you just pick up your arm, the thing is going to go automatically. Yes, and this is how it sounds. Thank you. connected to my Canton Ergo RCLs, the brown speakers you see over there next to the big white speakers. Suriname, the only place in the world where you have this music. This is how it is sounding, and I think there's something beneath this. Well, as you can see over here, this thing is not good on its place, you know. It's not perfect. It is not perfect, but this is what it is. This is what it is, and I think it's a lovely turntable, and I'm not sure. I saw different prices, not sure what the value of this thing is with the normal dust cap, but I'm going to sell it for €30, and so I'm not sure what the value of these things is with the normal dust cap, but I don't sell it very expensive. I'm going to sell it very cheap. I didn't pay too much for this thing, so I can sell it cheap, and I don't think I can ask too much. Even at the thing is almost mint. It has a little thing here, but yeah. From the front it is beautiful, you know, so the thing is as mint as possible, you understand what I mean? So the thing, I'm not sure, I would never buy a turntable like this with this ugly dust cap, and only the dust cap. If you want to replace the dust cap in a nice dust cap, it would cost you €120. But yeah, I described in my ad that the dust cap was not a nice dust cap, but we will see. Anyway, the guy will 100% buy it because I sell it very cheap, and with this original, maybe it is finished. Maybe it is finished. The sound was not good. The sound was not good at all. This thing sounded a little bit better, and the Pickering, I still have it. I have it for many years now. This Pickering. And I just love it. I just love this thing. Anyway, this was the review of this beautiful turntable. It, you know, don't expect to have a very good turntable. I don't think it is a, you know, you understand, a very nice turntable to have. Just, you know, if you don't want to invest too much, this is a nice starting turntable, you know, for I think you can have them for 75 euro, 50, 75 euro, and you have a vintage turntable, and that's nice. But don't expect to buy a very good turntable. This is just a normal turntable, you understand? Nothing special, but I love the looks. I just love this brown color with this gray. Well, I just like the aesthetics from this turntable, you understand? That's what I like from this turntable. The looks is very nice, and yeah, maybe if you have a very good element, very good needle, maybe it will sounds better, but yeah, I'm not sure, you know. I don't like the sound of this turntable that much. Not sure what it is, but can't lay my fingers on it. Maybe it is just this one, because I noticed that the cable here inside, when I move it, I hear some noises and some sound. Watch this. I can put it inside, and that's not a good thing, my friends. Anyway, thanks for watching. Put those thumbs up if you like it, and for now I say bye bye.